Okay, what we have here today is the standard issue wire harness that I make for all bikes that have the bag amplifier in the bag. So basically what we have here is a whole harness, follow the black line right here, that goes from here down the middle of the bike and branches off to the left here, joint here, and it follows to over here. So this scenario right here is set up for one amplifier in the bag, and the standard issue wire harness I make will have the additional to go to it'll be two sets of wires coming out of here, one set for the tweeters, one set for the two 6x9s in the bag. That's like the 1.5, where you could have one amplifier over here playing your tweeters in the back and operating the front half of the bike also. It varies on the amplifier you were using of how many speakers you actually get by with in one amplifier. So as it comes over here, you got your hot new ground, you got your fuse holder here, over the top, dumps into here, you got your hot and ground, hot is shielded, so you know you won't have any problem with leaving the bag off and it sparking up against something. One disconnect right here, which breaks it out to the front speaker wires, the remote hot, and the RCAs are all contained in one plug. And you would mount your amplifier like right here against the wall. This particular situation, we was able to get it right here. And so now we're finna make this bike into a 2.0, so we're gonna add the tweeters here, there, some more in the front, and a second amplifier. So stay tuned. But I just wanted you to see what I am. People ask, well, what are you doing? How are you doing it sometimes? And so I can give you parts of the pie. I can't give it all to you, but with a little imagination, a little know-how, maybe you can figure it out. We're gonna get this one right here upgraded, and we're gonna bring my man back to life, fully back to life. He already was in the game. I'm gonna put him on top of the game. So as you see, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Two more up in there. That's gonna bring us a total of 12. As you heard on the white bike, as a yonder bike, yeah, we're gonna be shouting soul over here for show. Yeah, we're gonna see how that customer response goes down. You may have seen this bike before because we had the dual blue bikes in here a while back. It was two blue FLHTs, you know. So one of them thought they was his and hers, but it wasn't. It was just him. The difference you could tell was the seats on the bikes. But yeah, we're gonna upgrade him, get him off that generic, and get him into the game. Money's Car Stereo. Let me see what I see. I see Harley Davidson. Over here getting it together, we got the deck up in here today, got the Sony in here, wire harnesses being recreated, got the Sony 7000 up in there, no sound as of yet, but yeah, because, well, I have nothing hooked up to it yet, but bam. probably tomorrow we might get some sound out of it. Well, we had the iPod plugged in, port one. It won't see it. So, plugged in the Android Auto, hence my phone. Okay, let's see if it brings it up. It's already switched over to the screen since my phone already had it. Bam, there we go. So yes, it does work with the phone, but it won't see an iPod. Okay, we got the flash drive plan. This is up home. Go to port one. No device response. Okay, port one, smartphone, USB, music, and videos. The other one says USB memory port, music. I did put some videos and stuff on here. Okay, now it's, oh, yeah, now it's reading it. So, let's see something. Bam, there we go, baby boy. So we know that works. We know that that's a USB port too for a smartphone and video. So yes, if you did have videos, you could play that. The phone mirroring thing, person did not ask for those options, so I didn't pursue those options. But yeah, so from there we can go to what option. Let's go to home. Got a home port two there. We got music. Nothing that nobody ever speaks of is this. This Sony is very touchy on the hand control. If you hold it, it'll run all the way to the top. So you gotta tap it up. Like so. If you hold it, it'll run. It'll run to the top. Also, with aftermarket radio, you can't move inside the folders, so you can only do both sides will go up or move the song. So, you know, oh, wait a second, I just saw something. Hold on, riding music. If you do this, it changes. Hey, I don't see that one. Okay. One thing. All bag. All front. So this will move the folders. I believe the owner would be more than happy. And we've been upgraded to 2.0. We got the four in the bag, four in the front, and four other items. So yeah. Mice Car Stereo. Zoom out, because I was too zoomed in. Do some wire cleanup today on this one. We'll be on to something else in a minute or two. Got some bags that got dropped off, so we're going to get on those next. Gotta go. FYI, to all the people putting lowers on the bikes, there are two different versions of lowers out there. You got the one for the older bike and one for the newer bike. The newer bike has this vent like this on it. And what's better about the newer one, because it is supported by this metal bracket. If you get the older style bracket, older style fairing that is, for the older bike, it'll be attached with two of these inside of here, which actually that's the only thing that's holding it on. So if you get the newer rounded style like this right here, it'll stay on the bike versus the old style. The old style, if you bump it, you'll snap those screws because the only thing that's holding it is the cap. The newer style is like this. It ain't going nowhere unless you have an accident. But yeah, Wayne's Cross Trail, tip of the day. We out. Sony 7000. Yes, it does work with Android CarPlay and Apple CarPlay. I played with that earlier. It does play videos if you put the bypass in, if you have a video on your flash drive. It does not read any iPod whatsoever, whether it's 6th generation or 4th generation. That's a minus. But in the case of if you have the generic stereo on your bike like this one had, which was the one with the 6 buttons with the orange screen, this is definitely a game changer for you. This bike previously was done by me, and we've upgraded to a 2.0 scenario. And what the hell? Oh. Hold on. Technical difficulties. Previously done by me, so he said, hey, you know, he want to take it to the next level, get off that funny style deck. And so people been requesting this a lot of their bike plan to get done by me. Talking about, Rod, walk back on it. Like, God damn it. Here we go. Let's start all over. So we'll just walk down the block. We can get about 2 or 3 houses. So, still backing up. The other day we was hampered by some lawnmower mute sounds, but I figure he's definitely gonna have an upgraded scenario. Oh, look, an old school. That's too old for me. But anyway, it picked up the Bluetooth from way over here. Can you believe that Sony from this far away picked up on the Bluetooth? That's pretty good. I'm gonna go about right here. This is the usual walking distance. So let's walk back in over here. So that Sony, that Bluetooth distance is, shit, that's what, 1, 2, 3, 4, about 5 houses out, you can get that Bluetooth action with a Sony. Now that's impressive. So I say it's a good update if you got the generic stereo. That's just my opinion. If you got the regular infotainment system, it's a toss up. How bad do you want to spend to get some videos? So yeah, the disadvantages is, well, like I said, if you had the original Harley-Davidson generic radio, definitely get off that and get onto this. The only thing I see this doesn't do, it won't tell you. God damn it. It won't tell you where the nearest Harley-Davidson is, and it won't tell you when you're running out of gas. There might be something getting made so this radio does that. I'm not really sure. Have to wait and see. I didn't even sync my phone to this thing and it linked up to it. That's scary. But yeah, that's about it for my thoughts on the Sony. Oh yeah, the other problem is this. If you hold the volume knob, it will run up all the way to the top. You have to tap it up. Do not hold the volume knob. It'll run up to the top like you just saw it do. So, that's all. We're out. So, in closing, if you got this radio, the Harley Davidson standard radio, you should get that radio. The XA 7000 or the 5000. Don't get the 1000. The 1000 is ugh. But the 5 or the 7. The 7 preferably is the one to have if you started off with this. It's a toss up whether you want this one or not. If you're gonna, if you already have a 19 bike, or if you have the 19 bike, I definitely say, okay, I like the 19 stereo. But this one is okay. I like the 19 one because it's smoother and it moves real fast. This moves okay. But if you got this over here, I suggest you get this over here. It does not play any iPod of any sort, but it does play flash drives and works off your phone pretty swell. Navigation is pretty neat if you like running through the phone, but I like my navigation to be separate from my phone, because like other people have pointed out, if you get caught in a dead zone, well, you just dead. With the Harley radio, it's going to tell you how much gas you got left when you get to the E line. It's going to alert you. It's going to tell you where the Harley Davidson dealership is. Those are things I like about that radio. If you have the older Harley Davidson radio, the infotainment before the new one, that's the 17 down one, and you're right at 50-50 who you're going to stay with. You know, it's a toss-up at that point. You know, the navigation works well on the other one if you put the correct zip code in. If you don't put the correct zip code, you could be in the wrong place. But if you really need that video in your life, well, this is what you got to do to get to the video in your life. You know, either, don't matter which one of the three radios you may own, if you want video, only way you're going to get it is switch out the radio to either an Alpine. The Sony is the one that fits on the Harley Davidson the correct way. The Alpine works if you got a Road Glide. You can put a True Double Din in a Road Glide, or the Alpine I used on a previous bike, the Media Center version. But on the FLHTs, this is pretty much the only radio you can switch it to, unless you switch it to a single din radio. Who wants to do that? So, yeah, and a few other tricks to make it work correctly. Different hand control units you need to own to make this happen. Once again, money's car stereo. Yeah, people ask my opinion. That's my opinion. Say, man. Over here, bumping out this truck. Extended cab Silverado. Got some tins under the seat. Nice box facing downwards. Amps under the seats. You know, it's playing pretty good. We got bumping that Bay playlist today because we in the Bay. I'm just going to randomly select some. Let me put it on function and put it on random. Let's see if we get lucky and see what comes up next. Oh, Bob Womack, we in the soul, so it's going to play random whatever it want to play. You know what I'm saying? But sometimes you get lucky when you hit random. Yeah, so you know, that's what I'm talking about, a little bit of soul, a little Marvin up in there. All right, let's straighten it out. Money's Car Stereo, you may have problems in your life with your music. Bring it on over here. We're going to straighten it out. We're going to get you right. Holla back. We done for the night. Money's Car Stereo once again, working it out. We'll end like this.
Everybody's gonna straighten out something sometime.
That's right, straighten it out.
I don't care how old you are or how young you are. I don't care if you're married, single, divorced.
Oh Lord, getting in the feelings. We're gonna straighten it out tonight. My name's Cross Stereo. It's done, it's over. I'm tired. Twin! Come get your truck, bring my truck back, baby. It's over. Tell a friend. This is how we get down over here. Money's Car Stereo. Follow me on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram. I'm here, I'm there. I'm a little bit everywhere. We out.